G'day, Dark Realmers. It's horror author and illustrator Michael J. Elliott here with you once again. And today I've got a movie that will chill you. Hey, if this is your first trip to the Diaries, welcome. Thanks so much for joining us. And if you want to keep up with the best in horror book reviews, movie reviews, a bit of creepypasta, and some Hollywood trivia, then hit that subscribe button and the bell notification, and you'll always be on top. Okay, Dark Realmers. Grace is a movie that just about ticks every box for fear and storytelling. And we're going to be looking at it right now. Yeah. Well, Dark Realmers, here's an interesting piece of trivia for you just to set you up for today's movie. Did you know that as Homo sapiens, we're hotwired to instantly feel a response towards babies and small animals, and to a lesser extent, maybe the elderly? It's in our system. We can't help it. Okay? And for anyone that looks at babies, or looks at baby animals and goes, oh, this movie is for you. Okay, well, okay, when I say it's for you, okay, maybe not in a awe sense, but as a horror movie, it's great. Okay, now Grace was an independent movie written and directed by Paul Sollert, and it stars Jordan Hall as Madeline Matheson, and also as a brilliant co-star is Gabrielle Ross, or Rose, sorry. As her mother-in-law, Vivien. Now, the story revolves around Madeline, who's been desperate to have a baby. Okay, she's had fertility treatments, she's had no luck with it, and she is married to Michael. Okay, and finally, they manage to get themselves pregnant, okay, and it's joy all around, but the joy is going to be short-lived, okay, and the creep will take over. And just to set you up so you know what you're in for, here's the trailer, Dark.
We got pregnant twice before she came. Accident, she told us that she was going to carry the baby to term.
The baby's dead.
She'll deliver on her own in 3 weeks.
Stay.
You can't wheel a baby back to life.
Her name is Grace. The stars in heaven have tucked in the sun.
That baby is sick.
Please, we need to eat something.
God, Madeline, you look terrible.
I do not want this woman raising my granddaughter.
Grace! You don't understand. She needs special food. Please!
Okay, Dark Realmers, that is one of the most effective creepy trailers I've seen in a long, long time. Now, what makes this movie great is that Grace isn't you know, the daughter of Satan. She's not a demon possessing a baby. She's not a changeling. The baby is dead, okay? Hence the flies around the crib. They know that this child isn't really alive. You know, it's just meat. It's fodder. The scene where, you know, Madeline's brushing the child's hair and it starts falling out. You know, the rash on the baby's side, which is just the baby falling to pieces unless it gets human blood. That's frightening. That is really frightening in itself. And writer and director Paul Sollert has done a fantastic job. Not only has he written this movie in such a way that the horror is very subtle, almost ethereal, but the performances are just standout. And the way, you know, the characters are set up. Now, there's a scene where Michael and Madeline have his parents around for dinner. And straight away, Vivien, you know, talks about, you know, the birth of her grandchild, you know, of course, you know, at the hospital and that. And Madeline says, no, I'm going to have natural childbirth, because Madeline's a vegetarian. She believes in natural remedies. She doesn't kill anything. You know, she'll shoo a fly out of the window, that sort of thing. So she's very new age, very sort of progressive like that. Michael's a little bit dubious, but he goes along with it. But Vivien is a starch matriarch, and she says, no, you know, you'll have my hospital. And the dynamics of their relationship is set up perfectly in that scene. Now, because she doesn't eat meat, Madeline has made some sort of, you know, vegetarian dish, and the look on Vivien's face when she's dishing herself up some. And her husband Henry, you know, he's basically a human handbag. He doesn't say anything, and when he does, he's put straight back in his place by Vivien. So we can see, you know, who has all the power in the relationship and how she tries to dominate, you know, Madeline. Now, as I said, you know, Gabrielle Rose is brilliant in this movie, and some of the most creepy scenes come not just, you know, from Jordan Ladd, the actress, but from Gabrielle Rose herself. Now, after Michael dies, she becomes very maternal, and there's a really creepy scene in this where she, you know, gets her husband Henry and she gets her breast out, and he thinks she wants sex. No, she wants him to suckle on her, to nurse her. That is really, really disturbing. Then she buys a breast pump, okay, and there's a scene where she's feeling how full her breasts are, because she's just so, she won't accept the loss of her son Michael. She's determined that she's going to get this baby away from Madeline. And the scene where she's just sitting in Michael's old bedroom, and it's been kept as he was when he was perhaps just on the verge of becoming a teenager, but it's very much a child, and it's almost like a shrine. That sets up how well this character's mind works and how we feel about her, okay? There's some fantastic, really creepy scenes in this, and it's, as I said, done very subtly, you know, gently, but that's what makes it creepy, Darkrealmers. Even the dialogue, you know, it all serves a purpose in this movie, okay? And one of the key scenes is where, because she decides that she's going to go full term, and even though the baby's dead, she's going to deliver it just as planned, and she's in the birthing pool, and the sound of drums, which are very reminiscent of heartbeats, overrides the whole scene, and it's just chilling, okay, knowing that this baby is dead and being brought into the world. Look, this is one of the best movies I've seen in a long, long time, Darkrealmers. And once again, it's an indie film. So it certainly shows that you don't need huge budgets. You don't need vast amounts of special effects to terrify an audience. If you do it with the right script and you get the best out of your actors via your direction, you can do it. Look, I thoroughly recommend this one to you, Darkrealmers. And you can find this either on Netflix, or you can also find it on Blu-ray and DVD, okay? And check it out for yourselves. Now, if you've seen it, let me know what you thought of it, okay? And if the trailer and what I've said about the movie has inspired you to see it, also let me know in the comments, okay? So, until next time, this is Michael J. Elliott. I hope you've enjoyed my review of Grace. Okay, and as I always say, if you're going into the maternity wing, either to visit someone or maybe go in for yourself, okay, please stay in the light. So until next time, Darkrealmers, bye for now.